Many people have been saying stand with farmers for a while now. But there's one issue that no one really seems to be talking about. This issue involves farmers, their daily lives, Microsoft, and the Ministry of Agriculture. And it looks like farmers have little say on what's going on.
Now, as per reports, the government actually wants to link multiple databases of farmers' information, you know, like from PM Kisan, crop insurance schemes, and so on, and also geotag their agricultural assets, and then hand over the information of 50 million farmers as well as their land records to Microsoft India's local partner, Crop Data. But to understand where this started and what's really going on, we need to take a step back and look at something called the AgriStack.
The AgriStack is a collection of technologies and digital databases proposed by the central government that focus on India's farmers and the agricultural sector. The government claims that this is being built primarily to tackle issues of low credit and wastage in the agricultural supply chain. Under this project, every farmer will be provided a digital ID that will be linked to their Aadhaar card. Furthermore, a lot of their data will now be collected, including household size, profile of the land they hold, production history, and financial history.
Now, if the government is going to be collecting so much granular information about the lives of millions of Indian farmers, surely there has to be a really good justification for this, even according to the directions of the Supreme Court of India in the Right to Privacy judgment. So, what are the government's justifications?
So, the Niti Aayog has said that a lot of issues such as inadequate access to credit and information, pest infestations, crop wastage, poor price discovery, and yield forecasting can be done through the use of digital technologies. This will be done through both market and state mechanisms focusing on four key areas: financing, inputs, farming practices, and supply and distribution.
Now, fair enough, I guess, but a pertinent question to ask at this point is, did the government actually, you know, have a robust consultation with farmers' groups, ask them how they feel about this incoming policy, considering just how much data the government, you know, is going to get into its hands of the farmers, and then potentially also share with private entities like we've already seen in this Microsoft MOU case?
Actually, no farmer organization seems to have been consulted during the formulation of these policies, just like with the farm laws. What's more, the blueprint for the AgriStack is actually in its final stages, according to the MIT. Shouldn't farmers have more of a say in this? Of course, Indian agriculture would benefit from the increased use of digital technologies, but doing so in a manner that excludes the main beneficiaries would make existing problems worse. Databasing, which is then utilized towards algorithmic decision making, is risky. Now, since the Personal Data Protection Bill 2019 is yet to be passed, implementing the AgriStack without addressing all these issues is a big concern.
Now consider this fact. Farms actually generate a lot of data. So there has to be some sort of privacy concern here. In fact, in their bid to provide better services to farmers, agri-tech and fintech businesses may actually end up harvesting and processing a lot of their data without the informed consent of these farmers. Further, in some situations, banks and insurance companies may actually have more information about the incomes and businesses of farms than the farmers themselves. And if farmers cannot adequately, gauge the value of their own data, then they may also be inadequately compensated for it. Now, really, the question here is, if farmers' privacy is impacted, what is the effect of this on their lives going to be?
Microfinance and fintech companies may target farmers in dire need of money with unethically high rates. For example, the Chief Minister of Assam, Hemanta Biswa Sarma, has spoken about the harmful effects of these entities in rural Assam, which in his words have had a very negative impact on society and even led to women compromising their chastity after failing to repay debts. Besides, the current framework extracts a lot of sensitive financial information without solving credit issues. Remember, 86% of India's farmers are marginal or small, so they have to resort to debt-funded consumption. Additionally, given the incomplete nature of land records in India, farmers may also be vulnerable to land grabs by large agribusinesses. If you remember, Aadhaar has led to the exclusion of a lot of people, especially those dependent on government welfare. Its verification systems are rife with technical errors such as biometric failure. Now, what is the use of adding one more database without adequately addressing the pressures faced by small and marginal farmers? In a model which has created indebtedness amongst 52% of agricultural households and led to the debt of 364,992 farmers by the end of 2019. Algorithmic decision-making may further reduce farmers' agency if and when it starts to gain prominence and starts impacting legal rights. Thus, algorithmic liability and transparency need to be sorted out before algorithms start making decisions about input costs and allocations.
as we can see, there are so many problems with this AgriStack project that we're not paying enough attention to yet. But again, Rohin, what are the solutions? Considering that technology is, again, not a bad thing. You know, getting technology into agriculture is not necessarily a bad thing. So what are the recommendations that you can give to the government to make this project better?
So there's a lot the government can do. In fact, we and 50 other organizations have written to the government asking them to do these things. The question is, will they listen? So firstly, the government needs to conduct wide-ranging consultation with farmers and listen to their suggestions. Secondly, academics, technologists, civil society and digital rights organizations need to engage with the AgriStack both as a policy framework and in its execution. This would require long-term study and engagement that should ensure that farmers are provided a space in these discussions. Lastly, the relationship between personal data and data policies in the context of India's upcoming personal data protection law also needs to be analyzed.
Okay, Rohin, so my takeaway here is that if there is any proposal which seeks to solve the problems that plague Indian agriculture, they need to first tackle the fundamental causes of these issues to begin with, and second, involve farmers in the process, both of which the AgriStack has failed to do.
So the current model relies on tech solutionism. We've already seen this in Indian agriculture with the Green Revolution of the late 60s. Where even though modern technological methods were used to bring about exponential increases in yields and output, severe inequalities arose in rural areas while environmental problems cropped up. Thus, the need of the hour is a holistic solution. Ultimately, technology is only as useful or harmful as its usage. Now, digital technology has already brought about such massive dividends to our species, and so we must not be afraid of embracing its power. However, we must remember that such technology is a tool to be used as part of a solution to fix a societal problem and not the entire solution itself. Right now, India's farmers have decided to brave bad weather, police lathis and water cannons to fight for themselves. The least the government can do is to ensure that they don't end up as guinea pigs in a bad experiment.